Last Friday, what we have covered is we talk about grouping functions, operators, clauses. I mean, we talk till operators only. We are going to discuss clauses, and I have given 10 questions as assignment for the weekend. Okay, now what we are going to do? First, we are going to discuss on the assignment completion, and if you have any queries on the assignment, we are going to talk about it. And after that, we are going to talk about clauses, which are where clause, having clause, group by, order by, followed by sub queries. Okay, so as first we need to verify the assignments. So Shahrukh, can you say share your assignments and we'll discuss on the assignments?
Sure.
Go ahead. You want to share in the Telegram or you want to share your screen and explain?
I want to share and
So what you can do, give me your questions and answers. I will be discussing and giving the answers once again. Assignment verification.
Over here, I just changed my table names because I already had it, so I just...
It's okay, no problem. Okay, so write a query to find the details of the employees whose job is clerk. Whose job is clerk? The question is, write a query to find the details of the employees whose job is clerk. What does it give? The answer you mentioned job like clerk. I clearly mentioned whose job it is clerk. Given exact namings, right?
Yes.
What is the answer you given is, you put a while character. Yeah. So, for example, this is what you written as an answer. I mean, this also will work, but I'll tell you the problem statement, what is the problem here. For example, let me update one record or insert a record. Employee ID. Okay, now here my requirement is write a query to find the details of employees whose job is clerk. Okay, the answer what you given is this one. So in this way you are getting this record also, clerk assistant. But my requirement is I need only clerk, job as clerk actually. Using this your answer, we are getting one more record which is not required.
I bet you just, I can use, just a minute,
yeah.
I'm gonna pick.
No problem. I will tell you, give you my feedbacks, so you can give it at one shot actually, okay?
So I can put only, these percentages, I can put only the back, in the beginning, sorry.
Can you ping me the correct answer? I'll tell you again the problem statement there.
Yeah.
Okay, this is your answer, right? Correct answer.
Yes, it's
yeah. Yeah, no problem. Version 2.
Yes, I confused it. We should put in the beginning or in the end.
Okay, no problem. I'll tell you the problem statement here also. So now you kept it here like this, right? Let me insert one more record.
Come on, right now you are putting in the beginning, yep.
Yeah? Yeah, of course. Now I break your code.
Yes.
Now tell me. Yes, your code is broken. I'm a good tester actually. This is what I don't want this record. Now tell me. This is how you have to test it actually. All these scenarios. A good tester can be a good developer.
But we should apply like, yes?
I don't see. I don't really bother. You should apply. Did I mention anywhere you should apply a like? I did not mention anywhere that you should use this functionality only. Okay. This is my requirement. Write a query to find the details of employees whose job is clerk. That's it. That's what my question. You want to use which concepts? Up to you.
We can put in.
Try it out, I'll break it. You put your ideas.
Of course you break.
Just ping me the answer and I'll get the water. Okay, I'm back. You're pinging the answer, right?
Yes.
Okay. Eighth question, you didn't complete or it's incomplete? Are you missing something? Eighth one.
I didn't complete yet. You asked it to ping, that's why.
Okay. So I verified the answers. Eighth and first one is incorrect. Rest everything is fine.
Okay. Because I didn't do 8.
Huh, no problem. I'm telling 8th and first question is incorrect answers. Rest everything is good. Okay.
No I couldn't do first one.
Okay.
In this case.
Okay. Okay.
But it's not working.
Anyway. No problem. I'll explain it quickly. So this one. It's after telling the answer, you will say, "Oh, this is simple." Okay.
Really?
Really. This much only.
No composition, nothing, just.
I need job equal to clerk actually. Write a query to find the details and imply whose job is clerk. That's it. Okay, if you see this question actually, 9th question, write a query to find the details of employees whose name starts with S. This is the right one, what you have done. If I mentioned whose employee name starts with clerk actually, you should do clerk like this actually. But I didn't mention the question like that, right?
Yeah, that's your point.
Right? And 8th question you want to complete or you want me to explain? 8th
yeah,
one.
I will complete it.
Okay, you can quickly pick the answer and we can move the next topic.
Not equal to.
You write it and ping me the answer. Okay, if you on some time, by tomorrow you can submit the 8th one actually, okay?
Sure.
Okay, no issues. Rest everything is fine. Only first question and 8th question. First question we are done. So 8th question you can submit by tomorrow.
Sure.
And thank you for your proactiveness and completing the assignment. Okay. I'm happy for seeing the assignment answers. Okay, so with interest of time, we move on. Any questions in the last session? Any topic you want to touch base once again? Or anything
yeah.
You are not clear?
Can you do exist?
Exist.
One more time.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Sure. Okay, so where 1 equal to 2 means it's a, I'm just making a false condition. Okay, so when where 1 equal to 2 means it will not give any data set.
Over here, I got this point, just I didn't get, for example, in the beginning you put another table, and over here in the brackets you put another table.
I'll show you the, actually I'll show you the use case, when do we use exist actually. In subqueries, this is subqueries, actually in subqueries we use exist mostly. I'm going to give a the real correct proper example with exist actually, in the because I need to complete subqueries, then only I can use exist properly actually. So for demonstration purpose I'm trying to make it out, probably because I need to explain what is this actually first. Actually this is a subquery. Okay, can you ask this, can we discuss the same point in the subqueries?
Sure.
Okay, I think in that point of time it will be more clear for you.
Sure.
Just a moment. Okay, so in the interest of time we'll move on. In the last class we are talking about operators. We talk about different type of operators. One is arithmetic operators and one is comparison operators. After that we talk about logical operators, and we have done some assignments. Okay, so what we are going to do today, so one operator is missing out, which is set based operators. Okay, assignment verification done. Recap. I can say done. Any questions? Part of exist, Shakruk? Any other doubts you have in the last session?
No question.
No question. Okay. So we'll talk about today set based operator. What are the types of set based operators? Basically, why do we use set based operators? To combine the data set, we use set based operator. First of all, what is data set? Data set is nothing but a group of rows. Okay, let me show you an example. Let me take customer ID, customer name, and customer. Okay, two is enough actually. One, two. Let's take 10 records. Okay, what we call, this is a nothing but a data set actually. Okay, if this is one data set, and we have one more data set. Okay, this is data set name is A. Data set A. One more data set is there. Data set B. With data set B. Okay, data set is nothing but a group of rows. That is a simple definition of data set. I have two data set. To combine these two data set, we use operators called, different types of operators are there. My requirement is I need to merge these two data sets. When I say merging means, this data also should come. Okay, let me call it as here. I want to put this on the merge it on the single data set. Merged data set of A and B. I want to merge it actually. So this data set should come here. this also should come here. This is a merge. Getting your point? So I have two data sets, A and B. I need to merge it. So for this purpose, we use a concept called set-based operators. There are different types of set-based operators that I'm going to talk about in detail. This is a data set one, this is a data set two. I want to merge it. Is it clear? What is data set? It's a group of rows. Able to understand?
Yes.
Perfect.
Yes.
Perfect. So now to do this one, we have union. Let me talk about union all first. Union all. Union. Intersect. And except. We will talk about it in detail. What are these and where do we use which one? For all these things, there is a few rules are there. Rule number one. Rule number one. Number of columns between the two data sets should be same. It can be two or more. I'm just taking example two only. It could be more than two. It's not like only two. It could be more than two. Between two data set should be same. Instead of two, I say between data set should be same. Rule number two. Data types, or I can say data types between the data set should be same. I will explain these rules in detail once again. And order of the columns should be same in all the data sets. These rules we have to remember throughout our when you are using set-based operators. Okay, so let me elaborate more in detail about what are the number of columns between data sets should be same. When I say this, for example, this is a data set, and for example here data set I have one more column called customer mobile. These two I can't merge it. Actually it will say that it will not work, it will throw error. Then if you are in the data set A, if I have two columns in the data set B also, I should have the two columns only. Or in data set C, if I have one more data set, data set C, you should also have the same columns. Okay, you can have multiple data set, your number of column between the data set should be same. Okay, column name might not be the same. This one, column name could be anything. Here it may say that customer ID, no problem, still it will work out. Instead of C name, I'll say customer name, there's no problem about it. Okay, so number of column between the data set should be same, that is a rule number one. Rule number two, data types between the data set should be same. This is integer. Okay, in the data set two, if I'm putting customer ID as ABC, it will not work, it will throw error. Data types between the data set should be the same. Okay, if it is integer, this also should be integer only, then only it will work. I'll show you practically. Order of the column should be same. For when I say order of the columns is, here you mention customer ID. If I do reverse, again it will be a problem. Order of the column should be the same. Okay, let us see practically how this is going to work out actually. Let me create some data sets to demonstrate the examples. Okay, let me filter out. Okay, and this is I will take is this is a data set one. Okay, this is data set A. Let me take data set B also. Okay, let me delete this. This is not required. Okay, data set B I will take department 20. Can't do that emerging cell. One second. Let me take data set 3. Okay, now our goal is we need to merge these 3 data sets. Okay, our goal is we need to merge these 3 data sets. That's our job. Now let me show you in the practically. This is my data set 1. This is my data set 2. This is my data set 3. So rule number 1. What is rule number 1? Number of column between the data set should be same. How many columns are there? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here also 8, here also 8. Then no problem. Rule number 1 is passed. What is rule number 2? Data type between data set should be same. So data types are same because I took from the same table just demonstration. It is same. Rule number 3. Order of the column should be same. Yes, order of the columns is same. So all rules are called check pass. Now how do I merge it? To merge it, we have two things actually. We can do use union null and you can use union. Both are we will give the merging actually. But there is a difference between these two concepts actually. Let us use union null first actually. One single data set will come. First 10s, 20s, 30s. To merge the data set, we need to use union null. The same concept will come in SSIS also. Same concept. At the time, I will ask the question, you should tell me. Same concept will come, we will be discussing in the 6th week of the course. Same concept I will going to ask you. We need to, at the time, you guys need to remember the rules and everything. Okay, now is it clear? Union null is clear?
Yes.
To merge the data multiple data set, we use union null. Why then? Why it is why we have concept called union? Okay, I will show you the drawback here. let me insert. Let me take this data set once again, just for the demonstration purpose. Now, if you see here data set 1, good. Again, the same data set came here. It's a duplicate data set, right? 7782, 7782. Clark. So it's a duplicate data set. Okay. Here we can avoid the duplicate problem different ways actually. Here I can put distant. One second. Not here. By department number, I will talk about order by all these things. So here, if you see, I use union all, I got a duplicates. Okay, so now if you want to remove duplicates, we can use the distant clause. This is what is distant. I will talk about separately. Okay, so basically, I need to remove the duplicates. There is a concept called to remove the duplicates in the data set. We can use the concept called union. Okay, here I have the problem statement here is I have duplicate data set in the union null. So to remove this one, what we can do, you can use take the same thing. Everything rest everything is same, just remove all Now if you see here, your duplicates will be removed. Getting my point? You can do order by.
Yes.
You can do, yep.
If we don't use, if we use only union, so what's gonna happen?
Good question. It's one of the interesting question. I'm going to tell that. If you okay, instead of using union, why can't you use union? That is a question, right?
Yes.
Good question. I'm going to explain that part. Okay. So till here, everything is clear.
Yes.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Okay. So union. So the main the difference union all we have duplicate records. To avoid the duplicate, so we need to use a concept called union. Actually, union. What is union? Union is nothing but. Let me write it here. Union all plus distinct. Then you can ask me what is distinct actually. Actually, I will ask some questions actually. Okay. Assume that I have a duplicate records. Let me take customer ID. You have in your dataset you have 1, 2, 3, 4. Let me take customer name. It will be more clear. Customer name. I have Vijay. I have XYZ. I have PQR. Again I have XYZ. Again I have Vijay. Take a small data set. Now here we have, by seeing only we can tell it's a duplicates. Customer name Vijay is duplicated twice, XYZ is duplicated twice. By seeing only we are able to tell. Now but how do we identify? How do we identify? Okay, this is your duplicate, this is your duplicate. Okay. Now here I given a simple example, 5 records. By seeing we are able to tell. If you have thousands of records, how do you do that actually? To identify duplicate, first we need to do sorting, right? I'll show you how to do that actually. Okay, I did a sorting, perfect. PQR is occurring one, just give a number, okay, 1 and Vijay 1 and 2, XYZ 1 and 2. Now take example, this is some duplicate priority or duplicate whatever it is, just to put as a row number or rank or something like that. Now filter out rank greater than 1 and remove these two records. These are your duplicates. So what I have done, first I did a sorting on the data set, then I did a numbering, then I identified.
But you showed in Excel.
Inside.
How it's gonna work in
right. When I use a distinct in the background, whatever I explained here, the same thing is going to happen in the background.
Yeah, I got you.
Okay, so just to give an addition, union all will contain duplicates also. To remove duplicate records from the union all, we need to use distinct. Union all plus distinct is nothing but a union. Now you tell me that what is the difference. Union all is a heavy operation because it has to perform two different operations actually. First, it has to measure the data set. After the measuring the data set, it has to remove the duplicates. So union will have a performance issue because it is a heavy load, costly operation. Will have a performance issue. Okay. So as per the as per the requirement, if a union is not required, we should not use it. Okay, if something, if you can do it, you do it with union all, recommended to go with union all because you will have better performance. Okay, so we need to go with union all. We need to go with union all wherever it needed. Union only on need basis. Am I clear? Shokru? Clear for you,
yes.
Also?
Yeah, it's clear. And can you show your Cory?
Yeah. Yep.
And over here, you.
I'll paste this Cory.
You inserted another one, yes? For Union. Over here.
No. I took the same. I took the same thing. I just put it here. Union.
But it means we should write this query with Union.
Yes, Union. Union is a keyword.
Yeah, I got you. And if you have like 1,000 rows, how can we do? We should apply for every row. Every
No. This is a data set actually. Okay, it could have 1,000 rows. It's a multiple. This is one source. This is another source.
Gotcha point,
yeah. Got me? Okay. Yeah. I will paste this in here so that.
DJ?
Huh?
Table.
Okay. Guys, shall we take 10 to 15 minutes break? A carpenter came, so I just need to address him. Give me 10 to 15 minutes. Now that we can take a break for 10 to 15 minutes and we'll ping you once the work is completed. Okay, stay online. I'll ping you this one and you can refer it once. Just relook into the topics. Okay, thank you. Hello. Hello. Hey, sorry. Carpenter came, so that is our problem. So we are clear on the union, all on union, or any questions are there? If not, I will explain once again.
No, it's clear.
It's clear? Okay.
Yes.
What will be, you can have a I'll just give you a high level on the union and union all. Probably after that you can have a look on the video. It will be clear for you. Okay.
Sure,
basically, basically we have two data sets, or more than two data sets. We need to merge it. Okay. To merge it, we need to have a operator called set based operators. In the set based operator, we have four concepts. One is union all, intersect, and expect. Okay, union all is basically there are certain rules are there to merge the data set. Rule number one, number of columns between the data set should be same. Rule number two, data type between the data type and data set should be same. Rule number three, the order of the column should be the same. So number of columns in the sense, for example, this is my data set one. If you see how many columns are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Remaining data sets also should have the 8 columns only. You should not be 9 or you should not miss 6. Okay, the number of columns should be same. The data types between the data sets should be same. And the order of the columns should be the same. These are the three rules we need to follow when we are working on the set based operators. Okay, so union all is a keyword to merge the data sets between the data sets actually. So this is syntax. Assume this is a data set 1 and data set 2, data set 3 and data set 4. To merge it, we use union all. Okay?
Yes.
And union, so union all, union is nothing but union all plus distinct. One second. Yeah. Union is equal to union all plus distinct. What is distinct here? Distinct is a keyword which you can remove the duplicate data from a data set. Okay. How do the distinct perform, distinct operation will be performed? Just to demonstrate that one, I use this Excel data. So this is my duplicate data set there. Okay. First we will do the sorting. After that we will do some ranking. After that we will filter out on the greater than one. Okay, these are the two duplicates. When you use a keyword called distinct, in the back end of SQL Server, this operation will happen. It will not be visible for us. But when do we use union and when do we use union all? What is the difference between these two actually? This is one of the interview questions. Just remember this point. Union all we'll give the duplicate data set, but union will have the better performance. Union will remove the duplicates, but it will have the slow performance when compared to union all. This is one of the entry question. What is different between union all and union? Both are absolutely same. Only is the union all will have contain the duplicate data set, but union will not contain the duplicate data set. The reason is union is equal to union all plus distinct. This is one of the entry question. More.
Question.
Yeah, please.
This thing basically is like how the duplicate, right? It doesn't remove the duplicate, but it's like the.
No. It will remove the duplicates also. So in this example. Yeah, it will remove the duplicates also. For example, let me take the same example with union all.
Mm-hmm.
See, if you see these three cards and this record, both are same.
Right.
Clerk, it's a duplicate record. If I use union, here how many records we got it? 21 records, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, if you use union, you will get 16 records. Meaning is that duplicate records are removed out.
Yeah.
Okay.
So then this
yeah.
Answer.
Yeah. So 21 is with the duplicates, 16 is without duplicates. Am I clear?
Yes.
Okay, this is the difference between union and union all. Remember this one. This is most repeated interview question and the same concept will have in SSIS also. Okay. So try to remember this union and union all is very important. Okay, now we are clear on union and union all. We go with intersect and except. Okay?
Thank you.
What will be, it's clear for you as you joined a bit late?
Yeah, I will check the video later.
Sure. Yeah, if post watching the video, if you have any questions. Okay, no problem. Okay, no problem. Okay. Okay. Intersect is in the sense common data set between the two data sets. Okay, let me give a demonstration. Common data set. How do I explain? Yeah. Okay, let me put intersect. Create new select job from employee. Let me tell first what is intersect actually. To explain that, I will go to paint. Let me take one circle. Let me take one more circle. This is the intersect actually. Okay, common part between two data sets is nothing but intersect. Okay, so to explain that in the example way, let me take where job equal, where department number equal to 10. We got department number related jobs, manager, president, clerk. These are the department 10 related jobs. Let me take department 20 related jobs also. Now here, if you execute both together, if you see what are the common part, clerk is common and manager is common and what else? These two are clerk and manager is common, rest everything is not matching. So when you put intersect, clerk and manager is the common, only common part is coming out. When I put a union, how many records will get it? Okay, let me ask the puzzle kind of thing. Now these are my two data sets. In the data set 1 I have 5 records, data set 2 I have 5 records. When I put a union, how many records I will get it?
10.
When I put a union, okay, I will present the data set once again. When I put it in, how many records I will get it? When I put union all, as you tell, 10, absolutely correct, no doubt about it. Union, how many records will get it? Union.
Yes,
the
balance.
Yeah.
8.
Huh?
8.
8. Yeah. Right, 8 is correct. So, let us see that. 10, what you said is absolutely correct. You are getting 6 only. But let's see, because it's removing duplicates, manager, out of these two records, one record will come, president is not there, clerk.
There's two clerk, maybe that's why.
Yeah, two records are there, out of two, one record will come. Okay, two clerks are there, right? One, two, and total three clerks are there, out of three, only one will come. Okay, so here two got eliminated. So remaining will be 8. Out of 8, manager, how many are there? 2 are there. Out of 2, only 1 will come.
And also 2 analysis 2 on the data set.
Ah, early analysis are the 2. Yeah, you are correct. Clear?
Got it. Yeah.
Got it? So this is the difference between union and uninal. Okay, so we are wrong, system is correct actually.
Which
okay.
It looks
It's join, kind of joins, but I will come to the joins later actually. Yes, you are correct, it's kind of joins. Okay, intersect.
Okay.
Intersect, how many records will get it? We already saw it. Intersect, how many records will come get it?
2, 4.
You should tell me. Manager. And
clerk.
But only common data set will come out actually. Common distinct.
So 3.
I think only manager and clerk will come as output. Yeah, manager and clerk. Yes, the reason is common data set and common data set. Manager is common, president, clerk is common. Okay, clerk here 1 is there, here 2 is there. But I'm going to get only distinct actually. Get my point?
Yeah.
Okay. So common part. This is the intersect. Rest of the rules remain will same. There is no change about it actually. Next one, accept. How many records will get first? Accept. What is that accept actually? Other than that actually. In the intersect, what we got? Common part. Except the name itself it's conveying other than intersect. If we compare these two, let me show the normal data set also without anything. Total I will get 4 data sets. 1 second now. Yeah, this is data set 1, data set 2. Data set 3 is the intersect, data set 4 is the acceptor. So data accept is okay. So here clerk and manager are the common parts. What is not common? Enlist clerk, clerk assistant, president. These are the not common part. These
and
two are
over here,
yeah.
Analyst also is not common. And why it's not coming? Because you applied union.
Yeah, no. Enlist why it's not coming is accept. Okay, so here the meaning is in the data set 1, this is the data set 1 and this is the data set 2.
Yes.
Okay, in the data set 1, accept data set 2. In the data set 1, it should be available. So if you see here, assistant clerk, it is available here, but it's not available here. So it is listed here. Clear,
yeah.
It's got it right? Yeah.
Got it.
Okay, these are the others clear or only Shakru kids clear? Clear, right? What will be still for you? If your internet connection is not good, you can. Yeah, okay. Thank you for your acknowledgement. We complete the set base operator with this example. I will put this example on the notes. Perfect. Let's move on as per the agenda. So we complete the set based operators. Yes, after that we are going to look on the clauses. Okay, today we'll stop till clauses. Tomorrow we'll talk about subqueries. Okay, so pay attention, this is very important. And interview question is here, what is the difference between where and having clause? Okay, this is one of the interview question. But let us look into what is clauses. After that we'll look each and everyone and we'll look at some examples. Okay, clause normally it's just nothing but a condition. Okay, when we say put some rules, they will ask what are the clauses, what are the conditions behind that. Actually assume that you got an offer in a company. Okay, there will be terms and conditions will be there. Your offer will be acknowledged once your background verification is completed, or your offer will be acknowledged once you accepted the offer letter. These are the clauses. Probably 6 months, first 6 months you will be in a probation period. There will be certain clauses will be there. There's nothing but rules or conditions behind that actually. Okay, so clauses in simple way is nothing but conditions on the tables. Let us look into the clauses. So assume that we have employee table. Now, as we know, basic thing, if I want to filter any data set from a table, we need to use where condition. Where clause or where condition, both are same. Assume that I want to filter on the department number 30. Okay, this is the department number 30, employees. Okay, this is nothing but a where clause. Syntax is select star from table name where column name and condition. What is the condition you want to put? You can put that condition. Okay, sorry. Okay, so substitute your things with actual tables. My table is employee department 30 condition. Clear? This is a where condition. It is as simple as that, nothing much complicated about it. Okay, let's look into having. We'll talk about after group by completion. What is group by? So in the previous session we talked about aggregate operations. Can someone tell each and every aggregation and what is the purpose? I mean, as a part of SOFIA, what are the aggregator functions in SQL and explain in detail? This is the question. Hello, I'm audible, right? Hello.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Okay, word will be dropped out. Okay, out of you both, you can one can explain what are aggregator function. If you don't remember, open your last class notes and look into the what are aggregator functions quickly.
It was from the last one, yes.
Yeah, in the last class, in the Friday's class, we talk about aggregator functions.
Could you look at it? I don't remember what was the aggregate exactly.
Yes. Let me open the previous notes. Okay, so yes, grouping functions. Aggregate functions. The terminology is both same. Grouping the data set. Okay, how many we talk about? Count, sum, minimum, maximum, average. Let us take one example. Yeah, SOFIA is available here. I will take once again to explain what is count, what are this actually.
Sure, okay. Just I don't remember the name, that's why.
No problem. Let us take out, talk about, I have customer name. And customer has purchased and amount, I can say, order amount. Okay, assume customer name Vijay and XYZ. Okay, PQR and maybe call XYZ. So I'm going to put one order ID. The rest I will order date. So Vijay placed an order on 30th August and he purchased for, let's say, for $100. Okay, XYZ placed the order on 27th August 2020 and he purchased for $50. Like that, maybe PQR also placed order and he put for $25. And XYZ 26th August and he placed order for, let's say, $75. Take example. So now the question is total count of orders. Okay, what are the grouping functions? Grouping function is nothing. Grouping, what do you mean by grouping? Is grouping of the data sets actually. Now what are the function we have? We have count function, count of orders. Total order count is 4. This is count, right? Sum of what? You can't do sum of customer name. You can't do sum of order date. You can do sum of order amount only, right? Sum we can't do on the customer name. I can't concatenate my customers. I can't do sum of order date. What we can do, sum on the order amount. Am I clear?
Yes.
So in Excel also, all these functionalities, whatever in SQL is there, it will be available actually. Sum is this one. What is average? So average of
amount.
We average, we can do the average, yeah. Average of order amount. What is average? Sum of the data set by number of record. If you do that, these two divisions, you will get that again 62.5. Sum divided by count is nothing but average. Simple mathematics.
Sure.
Okay. Okay. And sum average. What else? Yeah, minimum and maximum. Minimum of order amount or minimum of order date. Minimum you can apply an order date or order amount, anything is fine. Assume that if I take minimum of order date, it will give the least date. 26th August is the minimum date. If I do minimum of order amount, means, yeah, 25. Okay. Now, as you have only 5 records, you are able to seeing and by seeing and you are able to tell. If you have millions of records, it's very difficult to do that actually. Where we need SQL in that case. Maximum is as everyone knows, highest of the given records. Okay, these are the grouping functions or aggregator functions. Okay, both are same actually. Okay, in this is how I did in Excel. SQL is the same way. Probably I could have done some examples, right? Where is this?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, this is the query. Sorry. So same thing I had done in SQL. I think employee name column is not correct. SAL, okay. Okay, number of employees is 16. Okay, and the table is 16. Salary is the total. What is the salary? It's a total salary, right? Total salary is this much, and minimum salary is this much, maximum salary is this much, average salary is this much. if you do this divided by this one, you will get this back actually. Okay, but it will not, every time it will not be correct actually. Okay, you have to remember at which time, which case it will fail.
Zero.
Null. If I have the salary null. Okay, let me take one example. This count P2. Here if you see count, I'm getting 3. On count of order amount, I'm getting only 3. The reason is null will not be counted. If you take the count of order date, it will be 4. But if you take count of order amount, it will be 3 only. Okay, this is the order amount counter. Okay, if you take count of order date, order, this is order date, B column, it will be 4, but count of order amount, it will be 3. The reason is nulls will not be accounted. Am I clear? In this case, when you do average, it will be incorrect actually. Am I clear?
Yes.
Perfect. So these are the aggregate functions. Let us see how I'm going to correlate with group I. Okay, let us look into some more examples. Now this is my employee type. I'm going to work on this table only for time being. I need a I need a salary for each job type. I need a total salary for each job type. Or okay, let us take example something like that. I need a count of, for each job type I need a count. Mean what I'm trying to say is, now if you take filter on the clerk, how many jobs are there? How many employees are there under job? 4, right? So I need this count. If I take manager, how many are there? 3. If I take president, how many are there? 1. Like that, I need a counts. To do this kind of operations, we need to use group by. Job, comma, count of, count on what? Count, you can put job, you can put job also, you can put star also, anything is fine. Okay, you can put star also, you can put job also, anything is fine, no issues about it. Salary, it may be incorrect. The reason is, I will tell you a simple example. Assume that, okay, you kept it on salary. Assume that the salary is null. Your count will not be corrected, right? If I take only salary, it will be incorrect. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Nulls will not be accounted. So salary, it may be giving wrong impression. Either you can put star, either you can put job. Both are correct. Okay. So if I put a group by function or aggregate function in the select clause, it's mandatory you need to put a group by clause. Group by job. Group by means, in the simple term, for each job. When I say, when any question comes, for each job, for each department, for each employee, its meaning is that you need to use a group by. Okay. Let me rename this column also as count of records. So for analyst job, I have 2, and analyst clerk, I have 1, clerk 4, clerk assistant 1, manager 3, president 1, salesman 4. Am I clear?
Yes.
Perfect. So let's move on. I'll tell you one more example. For each job I want a salary. In that case, I need to do a sum. Sum of salary. Here you can put total salary. Total salary for each job. for enlist we are paying for 6000 2000 something like that for each job we are paying how much salaries this is sum what is the minimum salary you are paying for each job what do you do what is the minimum and what is the maximum you guys want to try what is the minimum salary paid in each job just correct it and give me back what is the minimum and maximum salary paid in each job
this table we have yes
I think you guys are having the same time because last time I ping you these tables I will ping once again so that Sophie also can create these tables just a moment you guys Sophie, you can in your I hope in your machine you have SQL Server. It's not there.
I can see it. Yeah, I can see that you.
No. My question is, do you have the SQL Server installed on your laptop, or we need to set up? No. Okay. Don't worry. Tomorrow morning, we'll set up in your machine all the tools required for this course actually, and after that you can create. Then you just listen things in that case.
Sure.
DJ, what we should find, minimum and maximum?
The question is, I need a minimum salary in each job and maximum salary in each job. These are the two questions. Minimum and maximum salary in each job. Okay, you can ping me the query once you complete it, please. Can you do it in single select statement? The same thing? Okay, what you done is correct. There's no doubt about it. Can we do it in single select statement instead of two select statements? I repeat. Can we do the same thing?
What do you mean by single?
Meaning is that when I execute a single this one query, I need to get minimum maximum both at one shot.
Ah, that's much.
Yeah. I'll prepare some questions for tomorrow as assignment. Okay, I will complete one more topic having class, and I will prepare some questions. Okay. Meanwhile, I will prepare some questions so that you guys can practice and come back for tomorrow. Okay. Odilvik, you can correct your assignment and send me get that assignment tomorrow. Okay? You are there?
Okay.
Yeah. So I am preparing for today's. I will prepare few questions. I will not
do much. Yes, I am.
Yep, correct. So, with this concept, we are clear on the group by class. And next topic is having class. I'll take the same requirement. Okay, now we did it using group by class. I'm able to find out for each job how much count is there. Now I want to find out the I need the jobs where the count of records more than 2. Basically what I need is, this is the data set of group by. Okay, I need more than 2. Okay, once this data set received, I need more than 2, greater than 2. I need these 3 records. To do that, we have a function called having count of job. You copy this, paste it here, greater than 2. That's it. Okay.
Yes.
Clear? So this is the having clause.
And over here, can you put like salary? Or
yeah, of course. We can do everything. Just a minute. I'll talk about salaries also. For each job, I need the sum of salary, and then my salary should be greater than 1000. So that is my question. Okay, these are the more than 1000. Okay, let me take more than 6000. Okay, more than 6000. Clear, right?
Yes.
Perfect. So this is the having clause, and we have one more clause called order by clause. What does it order by clause? Assume that I got the data set like this. I want to ones first, after that twos next, after that threes next, after that fours, after that. So to do that, we have a clause called order by clause where you can sort your data. Order by is nothing but sorting the data. Order by on count of records. Okay, ones came first, second, third, three and fourth. Sorting the data. You want to sort on job also. Job and count of records. First on the jobs, it will give preference to the job. So years will come first. Analyst and assistant clerk came first actually. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, in this analyst given the highest priority. The reason is in the alphabetical order it's sorted. So 2, after that 1, after the clerk, manager, president, salesman. This is how it's sorted actually. Okay, if you take count of records first and now job next, what will happen is it will happen in reverse actually. Okay, first it happened on the count of records column first actually. After that, it given a preference to job. One thing I want to put in descending, another thing I want to ascending. This is a descending. If you don't put anything, it will be default ascending only. You guys know what is descending, ascending? Descending means highest to lowest. Ascending means lowest to highest. A to Z is nothing but ascending. Z to A is nothing but descending. Right? So, highest numbers will come first is nothing but descending. Lowest numbers coming first is nothing but ascending. Am I clear?
Yes.
Okay. You can do it by defining the column length, or you can define it by the number. This is the first column, this is the second column, right? You can put 2 descending, comma 1 ascending. This also you can do. 2 means it will understand it is the second column, 1 means it will understand it is the first column. Both are same. Am I clear?
Yes.
Perfect. With this one, we have completed the clauses.
Yes.
Okay, I'll give some questions and for tomorrow's class get that answers. In the meanwhile, first let me give the download for the Sophie so she can put a download in her machine. SQL Server 2019 download. Here we go.
Click on the link downloading the server.
Yeah, it will download tomorrow morning. I'll get it installed on your machine. Otherwise, I'll share some videos. Oh, okay. If you have time, you can quickly go through it and install yourself. That's also fine.
Okay.
Okay. This is the download link where you can click on that link. You will have a download. Probably it will take 5 to 10 minutes to get it downloaded on your machine. Okay. Then tomorrow morning, I mean, for you today evening, we'll get it installed in your machine. Okay.
So
and
if
yeah.
To
sorry.
My download now. I wait right.
Yeah, just download and keep it ready. Tomorrow morning we'll install it. I mean, at evening we'll install it. I will give one more setup. Team viewer also. Software, TeamViewer. Some server. Actually, I can share this. Actually, you can download from my. I'm sharing this. No need to download from that link. Actually, you can take it from the. This one, when you double click, it will work out actually. Okay, it's already downloaded in my machine. Okay, and what next? So, this is the primary thing. These two things you download and keep it ready. Tomorrow morning, I will get it installed on your machine. Okay, okay. So, for others, I'm giving some assignment. I will give few questions for tomorrow class when you're coming. Just complete these things and come back, get it done tomorrow. I'm going to give questions on this group by things what we are discussing just now. Salaries for each department. In it for each job. Fourth question. To find the number of hunters working each day. Sophie, you can download it and keep it. Probably if you have time now, we will install it now only so that tomorrow we can just start actually. Okay?
Yeah.
You can keep it and ready. If you have time, you can install now only. I will take the control of
it. Just the two, the team viewer and the SQL.
right.
Okay. Thank you.
Number of employees. Okay. Each department only if the number is greater than 3. Sixth one. How many questions you guys want? How many questions you guys can do?
How many questions
are
you gonna give us?
Good. Good to see. Number
WAQ.
WAQ, write a query.
Oh, okay.
Write a query, that's it. working for each department. Okay, you take the seven questions, okay, for tomorrow class, do it and bring it. You can use employee table only, no other table is required. Okay, so with this topic, we are concluding for today's session. Okay, tomorrow morning, we will have a session from 5:45 PM of California time. If anyone wants to join, you guys can join. Okay, I will come. I already given the timings in the group. Okay, I will send that link also at maybe 5:30, 5:45 PM. You guys, if anyone want a recap or something, you guys can reconnect if you have time. Okay,
sure.
That's it for today, and we will catch up tomorrow at same time. Sophie, you be available. We'll set up your center. Okay. Thank you, guys. See you tomorrow.
See ya.
And Vijay, too, so today will be a good time for you to catch up with the some materials from the beginning, or at least.
Sorry. Can you repeat your question? I didn't understand.
Like today after the class, is it a good time for you to, like, go through some of the beginning?
Actually, yeah. Today, it will take 30 minutes or 45 minutes to set up the server on your machine. Actually. Okay, so now what we do is we'll try to set up everything on your machine so that tomorrow morning, for you today evening, we'll start the topics. Okay, I'll try to make sure you are in line with them actually. Okay, what I will do is I'll try to cover up main things so that you can understand when I'm speaking something. Okay, rest of the parts probably I will slowly touch up in the weekends or something. I'll let you know about the schedules actually. Sounds good for you?
Okay, wonderful.
Yeah.
Yes.
Now, what we are going to do is you have downloaded those things, right? The downloads you have done, right?
Yeah, I downloaded it.
Yeah. Can you double click on the TeamViewer setup.exe?
From the actual download link or from my computer?
Can you share your screen so that I can tell you?
How do I do that?
I'll tell you. Don't. Okay, to share your screen.